Hello, royal folks. It's good to see you all here again. This is your regular dose of royal news and analysis. But before we start, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. Thanks. So King Charles is known for being a particularly loving and giving grandfather. So for the first birthday of his firstborn grandchild, Prince George, on July 22, 2014, the gift had to be extra special. George is the oldest of the grandchildren, with Prince William and Princess Kate later having Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis, and Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's two children, Prince Archie and Princess Lilibet, the youngest of the brood. Queen Camilla's grandchildren Lola and Freddie Parker Balls and Eliza, Gus, and Louis Lopes are also now the king's step-grandchildren. On George's first birthday, Charles gave him a lavish Victorian-style shepherd's hut, which was installed at the King and Queen's Gloucestershire estate, Highgrove. The hut included everything from a wood-burning stove to a daybed, and is thought to still be a popular place for the Wales children to play in when they visit their grandparents in the country. When Prince William turned 7 in June 1989, his father installed a treehouse at Highgrove, which has since been renovated for him and Kate's children. George has also had an entire forest named after him at Balmoral, which Charles explained during an appearance on The One Show in 2021. He said, "This was a rather empty field that the farm didn't need anymore. The great thing was that I managed to plant it the same year that my grandson was born, the eldest George, so I thought I'd call it Prince George's Wood. It is really for autumn color and a bit of spring, but autumn is the magic up here. So finding all the interesting trees and shrubs that turn an interesting color is half the battle." George, Charlotte, and Louis are coming up to the end of their summer holidays, and it is thought they will be spending some time at Balmoral. Most of the royal family traveled up to the Scottish estate for the bank holiday weekend, where they were seen attending church on Sunday. Two members of the family were noticeably absent, however, as Zara and Mike Tyndall stayed in England so that Zara could compete in the Wellington International Horse Trials in Hampshire. The 42-year-old equestrian pro was cheered on by her husband of 12 years, Mike, and their three children, Mia, Lena, and Lucas. Zara performed on the final day of the competition, dressed in a navy blazer and white trousers, as Mike stayed on the sidelines looking after their young family. So what do you think about this news, guys? Thank you for tuning in to today's discussion. As always, I encourage you to share your thoughts in the comments section below. Stay tuned for more updates on the intriguing world of royalty. Until then, thanks for watching. We'll see you again with some more fascinating news about the royal family. Thank you.